interesting track and some interesting weather with a little bit of threat of rain out there, so it should be entertaining. And I just want to say that in addition to what we're doing here on Thursdays, and of course what the VWST is doing on Saturdays and MNR are doing on Tuesdays, just a little bit of a teaser. We're working on an endurance series that we'd like to start up sometime this year, a little bit later in the year, looking at 3 to 4 races, and they will be between 4 and 8 hours long, including driver swaps. So just keep your ears open. We hope to have some announcements on that in the next little while. So I think that'll be a nice, exciting development, sponsored by NARS, but involving John Uyen and a couple others for the administration. So just keep things going there. So tonight's race, Hockenheim. Great track, very interesting. Some really challenging bits here and lots of places to pass. We've got, as usual, a 60-minute race with the 15-minute qualification. And then we're off. So that's pretty standard for what we've been doing before. We've got live weather, as you know. So if anyone's been looking at the weather forecast, it looked kind of dodgy for the next couple hours, which could be kind of entertaining. Everyone's on Discord chat, so thank you very much. And as people reminded me, make sure that yourselves are either on push to talk or you've got your voice activation high enough that no one can hear you. During the quali and the race, please no talking except for safety issues, and during the warm-up, fill your boots. Start is, as we've been doing before, is we get to the starting grid in pairs, and on the green it's roll off in each pairs. We stay in pairs through the track. 100 kilometer hour is max speed for the pole and slower for corners. If there's a couple places where you feel like you'd like to get a little bit of distance, just zipper through the areas that are a bit more difficult. Think about the hairpin, for example. And then by the time we get back on the start finish, everyone should be back in pairs lined up, with one car length between the pairs and about an even left to right. We've been doing pretty good this race. During the formation lap, please, no weaving, hard acceleration, or braking. You can drag your brakes as long as you maintain a consistent speed. And the start line, as always, is as marked on the track, where your timing starts.
That's 20 minutes to go.
If during the pace lap, as we do the formation, have an off track, you stall, or otherwise use your place in the formation lap, let the field pass you by and join the back. Do not attempt to force or otherwise make your way back to your original position. Okay, the gap will be maintained by the rest of the grid moving up, so no moving up. Orange zone is from the start finish to T10. Passing is permitted, but as you know, if the stewards find that you were at fault for an incident that's reported, you'll be getting heavier penalties. So just take your time. I think everyone's clear on the blue flag. No one has to get out of the way, but everyone has to behave responsibly and respect each other's race and make clean passes. Okay. Track limits. You can see there are track limits, and rF2 is not shy about giving them out. Remember, you have to keep one wheel on the racing surface, which is inside the white line at all times, and that's the racing surface, then the white line, anything that comes after that. You're on your own when it comes to what rF2 may do you, or what your other driver colleagues may decide to protest. Pay special attention to T2, 6, and 8. Make sure if you're going to the pit that you're well right on pit entry. Get in on that pit lane and stay out of the way of everyone else. People watch for folks going into the pit. On pit exit, you've got a nice long pit exit. Stay inside the pit lane until the pit lane finishes. Then you can merge with traffic in keeping with the rest of the traffic around you. And if you're crossing the pit lane on entry or exit, or if someone crosses that pit lane on you while you're in there, that's certainly eligible for an IR by the competing drivers. Up to you for pitting. Don't forget the pit speed limit, and there's no ghosting. I think everyone's clear on applying the golden rule and putting in an IRR according to the CMS general competition rules. And be useful to have lights for today and make sure that they come out automatically or you just turn them on. Everyone's aware of escape. That means race over. I recommend if you do have problems, do control, delete, or pull your network cable, come back in and see if you can race, because of course there's points for finishing. I can take care of DQs until the race session. After that, no racemen available to do so. Penalty serving. If you have a penalty for a drive-through, stay on the fast lane at pit lane speed from start to finish. If you have a penalty with time in it, pull off behind the pace car, or sorry, the pace car, because it'll be in the pit. Do not go to your box. Serve your steward assigned penalty for the time that you need to, and then carry on. You have to count it yourself. And you have three racing laps in which to do that. We'll do a pit box check at the start of warm-up, and everything is clear on that. Just hit drive, request a pit before leaving the garage, and drive directly to your pit box if you can. And if you're the first one there, make sure that you center your car well over on the side so someone else can pull in beside you. Are there any questions? Okay. Just a note, a lot of talk this afternoon on the text chat about where information is and what it contains and where are the responsibilities of drivers. So I'll make it really clear between the web page, which talks about the series, the webpage for the general competition rules, which talks about rules for CMS overall, and then this briefing sheet, along with anything that might be in the info channel for this race, are the four places where you'll find everything you need, with very little exception. I work hard at trying to make sure that everything goes into the info channel or those three places. So I work hard making that happen. Your responsibility as drivers is to make sure that you've read the GCR, you've read the competition rules, and that you're staying up on what the briefing sheet for the driver's race says. I try not to repeat. There is some repetition, but I try not to repeat, and I try and keep the track sheet focused on the track, not the other stuff. So, yeah, it's tough to read, but it should become second nature, and a lot of this is boilerplate because it doesn't change race to race. So I will, and I have, amended the sheet for the next race, which is Nürburgring, to try and shorten it up and focus it some more on the race so that I'm not repeating things, but it does remind you that the GCR and the series page contain information that if you don't know it now, you need to look at. All right. With that in mind, I'm going to make myself an admin.
All right, Eric. 15 minutes left. That's 15 minutes.
I didn't hear that, Jill. I guess that's a good thing.
Okie dokie. We'll see if
there we are.
My quality is worth a crap.
All right, everybody. We'll go over to Q. Have a good one out there. Make sure you're respecting each other's hot laps. Have a good time.
Thanks, Matt.
Thank you, Matthew.
Am I able to join during qualifying?
Yes. Yep.
Okay.
You can join all the way up to restart.
Thank you, guys. Just was running a little late tonight.
Yeah, no problem.
Sometimes life just gets in the way.
That's the end of the session. P9.
Where do you select the pit box?
You should have a key map to request pit.
Okay. I don't.
Default key is P.
You get time.
Or space bar.
But you can check in your settings to see what you've got and put it to where you want to. Okay, guys, we're off to quali, so please, mic's off.
Okay, it'd be great if my car would... I don't know what was going on there. Let's try again. Ah, thank you, rF2. Sometimes it just does weird things.
Your exit's clear. Watch the white line.
Okay, Eric. We've got 14 minutes to set a lap.
Sector 1 is yellow. Green flag, Sector 1. You've got cold brakes all round. Be careful.
Yellow flag in sector 2. The track temperature is increasing. It's now 93 Fahrenheit.
Qualifying. Franco's a pro, so he should gather his walk. I think this is good. I don't want to get too up on his butt. Definitely a track cut. Still. 3.
I think P3 has binned it in turn 9. Sector 2 is green. The leader has just done a 141.7. Sector 3 is 0.5 off the pace.
Oh, that's a track cut. Kind of should be back to
yellow flag in sector 1. Sector 1 time's okay. Okay, Eric, 10 minutes to go. That's 10 minutes left. Yellow flag, sector 3. Green flag in sector 1. Your brake temperature's okay. Sector 2 time is okay. Incident in sector 1, yellow flag. Sector 3 is 0.8, off the pace. Sector Sector 1 is now green.
Careful, car on your right. Clear on your right.
Take an easy lap here, because if you look at my best time, there was no way I was going to make up more than 6 tenths.
Car on your left, clear left.
Has just done a 141.4. You've got 10 minutes of fuel remaining. The guy behind has just done a 142.1. Yellow flag, sector 1. Sector 2 is 4.3. Off the pace. Green flag, sector 1.
Tires. Step over. Fresh tires. Brakes.
You're a second off the pace in sector 3.
Early.
Sector 1 is yellow. Sector 1 is now green.
All clear on the right.
Too much. Not necessarily so bad.
Sector 1 is 0.3. It's off the pace. Sector 3 is now clear.
It's way late. Maybe not. Oh god. Step 4215. Brakes hard, turn in.
Your sector 2 time is quick.
Wow, good track cut. Hard on brakes. That unfortunately was not going to be a fast lap, so here we go. Hopefully we can find some clean track, but it is very busy.
Car approaching, stay behind the line. Let's get some heat into these brakes. Okay, Eric, 5 minutes to go, 5 minutes left.
Gas, rotation. Touch over. Yes.
The leader has just done a 141.4. Incident sector 3, yellow flag.
Okay, here we go, fast lapper.
P4.
Brakes, turn in. early.
Sector 1 is yellow.
Too far, rotation too much.
Sector 1 is 0.4 off the pace.
Not fast enough this lap, I don't think. Brakes too early.
Yellow flag.
Not in this first gear.
Sector 3 is clear.
Oh man, that's my teammate Johnny.
Sector 2 is 2/10 off the pace. The brake temperatures are fine. Just 2 minutes left, 2 minutes to go. You're a 10th off in Sector 1.
I don't know that I'm going to do much better than a 5. It's my best qualification yet, but I'm not sure I can do any better. Let's see.
Green flag in Sector 1. Sector 1, yellow flag. Green flag, Sector 1,
nice.
That's your quickest lap in this session. Sector 3 is 0.4 off the pace. Yellow flag. Sector 1 is green. It looks like Kelly has crashed in turn 2.
Series.
Sector 1 is 0.4 off the pace. The end of the session, P4.
I know it said it's the end of the session, but I have until the end of this lap to make a time. Okay, time to go potty.
Anyone else disconnected?
Matthew, you left the race.
Yeah, I'm coming back.
Okay.
The guys left the pits and don't let the guys in flying lap should be off.
Submit an IRR.
Sue him.
For what? Every race will be.
Put the lap together.
Yeah, who took out that brake marker on turn two?
Sorry, guys. I just lost connection. So I'm just loading back in now.
Yeah, I dropped as well. Something happened.
Yep.
I didn't. Impressive.
So just loading everybody back in.
And I imagine it's going to load the grid positions.
Hey guys, dumb question. I see where it shows you that the track's like 5% wet. Does it tell you like what the forecast is? And I'm just overlooking it, or you just have that one value?
No, there's no predictive capabilities.
Okay.
Yeah, forecast is like regular weather forecast. You can give you an idea, but the game doesn't tell you.
Okay, no problem. But it will change in real time or type thing?
Yep.
Yeah, it will. So, well done, Daniel. I think we've got the top, Mac for the Pro-Ams, and Oliver for the Ams. So, everybody, if you just, if you would please. So, congratulations on some great laps. And if you'd please hit drive and go out for the pit box check.
No.
Thank you. I love you all, too.
Okay, pit stop requested.
Yeah, and I'll pull up a little so you can get out.
Thank you.
All right, Jason, you and I are sharing.
We are together, Jeremy.
Oh boy.
Yep, got you, Franco.
All cars just disappeared for me and appeared again.
I'm with you, Daniel.
Yeah, the pit crew is ready.
Okay,
I think we'll see each other. And if we do, that's a bad thing.
I'm sharing with Josh.
Wayne Galvin, you're sharing with Eric Jacobs, it looks like.
Yeah, Gary, you got kicked again.
I think I may have to do a lap to get to my pit box.
Have I got everybody
with me?
You shouldn't need to. There's no person with a lollipop. It's just a red box.
Okay.
Big red arrow is red box.
It should be right in your garage or off to the right or left of it. By one stall.
Okay, I must have passed it. Let me back up here.
It's a flashing white box on the ground and three red arrows up above it.
Don't back up too much.
Tommy Teasdale, this is Paul Ibbotson. We're sharing, I guess.
Norm, you're sharing with Sean.
Yeah, I got you.
So, why the hell... It's connected from the server.
We're doing a triple box.
Yep, triple in the back.
Stop streaming porn while you're racing, Guillermo.
Wow, but how do you race? How do you
race? Give the motivation.
It? Yeah.
All right, I'm sorry, guys, but I've not seen anything. It may be because someone's parked in it.
There's a question. Did you hit your pit request button?
Yeah, David, did you hit your pit button?
Did you call for a pit?
Oh, I just did now.
Awkward.
I think I may have seen it. Is it like a red box?
Yes, a red flashing box.
Okay, yeah. I'm next to car number.
Red arrows above it. Oh man.
Eugene,
I'll be back, guys. I'm gone again.
Yeah.
We're together.
Sorry, James, but I need to position.
Hey, the car. Felipe, you really all you had to do was pull in next to me, not push me out of the box.
Who's with me? That wouldn't be Felipe.
I don't know if James Bowder is in semi pit than me or not.
I think so.
If you press page up, you should be third person view and you can see who is next to you.
Boy, I think I might be in with three guys, me and two other guys.
Yeah, the last couple rows are three wide.
Okay.
Yep.
Not sure who I'm next to, but I'm the one that's way out here on the left.
Yeah, David, this is Paul beside you, and then Tommy Teasdale's on the inside.
Okay, sounds good.
Okay. Okay, guys, I think we've got everyone sorted out, so you've got a couple minutes there to go out and just get yourself reminded what it's like driving the car with a heavy tank, and we will roll over to race.
Yeah, I wonder why we are even checking that boxes, movie? Like, no one ever pits in this race.
Your pit exit's clear.
If it rains a lot heavier, one. You just might.
Your brakes are cold, let's get some heat into it.
Yeah, it's going to be mayhem if you want to go into the pits.
Exactly.
So it's nice to know if you're getting in the box first, if you're going to be sharing, so you can try to angle yourself appropriately.
Yeah, that's true. And I'm sharing with someone. Is this a newer mod or something? Because I remember an older Hockenheim that didn't look as good. This is pretty good, actually.
That's 5 minutes to go. 5 minutes.
It's the Tommy 78 version.
I remember racing at Hockenheim that was a lot worse than this one. It was good. Looks like a DLC.
I'm sure Tommy will take that moment with great happiness.
Yeah.
He needs to work a bit in the track limits, but that's good track.
Their track limits.
Yep.
In all the wrong places.
Eventually.
only the places that you don't get time from it.
Well, I think Tommy's a big touring car guy, and they use white lines liberally.
Yeah, his touring cars are really good. I remember playing with those mods.
Everybody, don't forget to make sure you've had a look at the pit box, so you know how to get into the pit.
I'm 100% sure I'm gonna hit the wall.
Wow, what a great turnout, guys.
Yeah, it's been good through the whole series so far.
Yeah, that's been very good.
Porsche Cup is working.
So I qualified fourth. We'll see if I can hold on to it.
Yellow flag.
Track record. For example. That.
You were already gone, Paul. I just helped you.
Thanks.
Green flag section.
He already lost. He might as well have some fun with it.
Yeah, you got some latency issues there, Sean.
Matt, you're gone again. What are you doing?
Oh man.
Stop watching Guilherme's OnlyFans stream while you're racing.
Yeah, this is not a good day for me.
Are you watching the footwork cam?
Yeah, that's what I'm doing.
I usually wear very fancy
clothing. Acknowledged, pit stop requested. Watch your speed limit in the pits.
Did you check your, you had everything updated on your content? I had a car.
Box in, two.
Pickup car wouldn't load.
Box now.
Yeah, I'm good.
That's 2 minutes left. 2 minutes.
One more time.
The exit's clear. Stay behind the white line.
Yeah,
yellow flag
in
sector
in,
one. Your brake temperatures are fine, mate.
I wasn't sure what it was.
Was the to 26 to finish up a couple of yes.
You're breaking out up a little, Matt. Too. You may just have a connection problem.
Spot off.
I am.
You know,
your spotter.
My ping is still pretty good, so. I've also changed my
don't
sensitivity
spot.
Because.
Alright. No more spotter calls for you.
You know what a sensitive guy is.
This be me.
I like how much we're learning about Matt tonight. Sensitive, foot fetish.
There's so many things about me you just don't get without visuals.
Thank God.
You know, okay, there's a guy more combat. The car behind. This is actually starting to make sense.
Yeah, I
Who's
think
mother work on
sector one is clear.
Zero up here in Ottawa. Ottawa doesn't deal with above zero in February.
The warm up, it's unbelievable. It's going to be 7 Saturday in February.
It's crazy. Anything. This is the canal wreaking its vengeance. If no one can skate, you can't race. Yeah, I'm here now.
Okie dokie.
Yeah,
the leader has just done a 142.3.
How much fuel we got? We have 66 minutes of fuel. That
Let's see if I get to hang around.
Checkered flags out on P5.
Last, for the start of the green. On the grid, you're fine.
Yeah, I'm here. I'll see what happens.
We gotta get to the green, though.
Spot
Thank
on.
You very much for that.
This spotter is available.
Right, so
that's
everyone
the end
makes
of the session.
Sure you got your...
P5.
Your setup loaded, you're
Don't
happy.
Spot.
Okay, no more spotting.
So I finally remembered to turn the spotter off before the race start, so it won't bother me the whole time we do the double file.
The track temp is 89, the air temp is 50, Fahrenheit
still here. We
60
got,
minutes.
55 seconds to go.
Getting
all
close.
Of them?
Yeah, probably all of them.
All leaders? Thank you.
All the leaders, I don't know.
All the girls I loved, or something.
I'll race with many leaders in.
I think 100 is good.
I use freedom units, so
35
we're doing.
An extra 10 leaders won't slow me down.
Remember, a slow roll off in pairs. We've got 3 minutes to make the lap. That should be plenty of time. And then it's as the pairs cross the start finish, so make sure when you come around the final corner, everyone gets lined up nicely. Might want to slow down at the front so that we get people nicely arranged and we get a good start, and then we're off.
Floor it.
Boonk.
Copy that. No tire change at the next stop.
There's even a noise for the wiper.
Angus, you're next to me. Thank you.
feel the choke.
Good luck.
I'm feeling you're going to lead it.
Overton just retired from the race.
Yeah, just carry on without me.
Bam. You guys, I'm next.
Okay, Eric, the next car is Tonk.
Spot's on.
All right, I'm here.
Okie dokie, here we go. Whoever ahead of me is in my class. Need to get back.
Yellow flag.
Sorry?
I think P5 has binned it in the hairpin.
Star back,
green flag, sector 2.
Come on, guys.
You can pass me.
Yellow flag in sector 1.
Nice. All right, they're on your right.
It's a free pass.
Well done, Eric. Good pass. Nice front. P3.
So the name of the game is going to be saving the tires while staying ahead.
Go, yeah.
I'm going like Jones. I got lucky, last guy. Looks like he had to serve a penalty.
You're reeling. Galvin in. The gap's now 1.2 seconds. They're slow into turn 2.
Whoa, that is slow. Sketchy. Tires.
Oh, slower car ahead. This guy won't see the blue flag. He's racing us for position. He's the class leader.
He's also not my class though, so I don't care.
The gap behind is now 1.8 seconds.
It's on the brakes a little early. Not sure why the sector timer's not working, but that's okay. I'm not focused on times right now.
yellow flag. Keep your wits about you, mate. We think that Tonk has pinned it in Mobile 1.
Ooh, interesting.
Green flag Sector 3.
That's
the best lap in your class. That was 143.0.
It said it was the best lap in my class, but I don't believe that. But I'm not going to try to figure it out.
Sector 3 is yellow.
Only 53 minutes left.
Sector 3 is clear, green flag.
Oh, cramp in my foot. This guy, I can't tell. Late, super late, not slow enough, track up, technically. Anybody's gonna complain. On the brakes early there. It's really hard to judge coming off qualifying with no fuel and now having a completely full car of fuel. Tires are flat spot.
All right, Eric, don't be intimidated by this little shit. Make him work for it.
Car on your right, clear right. Side. Still there. Clear left.
Can I stick it? Yo, sketchy. Now, I may have passed a car, but he wasn't in my class. So it doesn't buy me a whole lot, but it does keep me moving forward.
The gap behind is now 0.9.
Beating up the tires. Jeez, left front's at 90 already.
Incident in Sector 2, yellow flag.
Is that the guys behind me?
We can see Mazier has gone off in the hairpin. Sector 2 is now green.
So even though it's 89% of the tires, they're already getting mega sketchy, so I've got to start adjusting brake zones already. sketch. This one, I think. So this Ben Kesby guy is wicked fast. So I don't know that I'm going to be able to hold him off forever anyway.
Sector 2 is now yellow. Incident in Sector 3. Sector 3 is yellow. Green flag in Sector 2. It looks like Mazier has stacked right in Mobile 1.
Looks like he's running.
Keep your concentration. Now. Make the bastard work for it. He's quicker than you into Mercedes.
I'm definitely not worried about Ben getting by me. He is more than welcome to get by me.
Galvin is now in the lead.
Let's just say that during practice, Ben was several seconds faster than me.
Time was 143.5.
Yep, he's got to run on me again. Really? But I'm catching Mac. Look at that. Need to stop driving in my mirrors. Oh God, nope. Everybody.
Tiny bit of aero damage, just ignore it.
Somebody hit me?
From the guy behind, the gap's now 1.0 seconds. Guy in front, the gap is 0.3. Your lap time was at 144.3.
I think his tires are toast. So the tires on these cars are really, really, really the problem. They barely last the hour, so it's really important to manage them. So I'm wondering if this guy hasn't managed them.
Make him do all the work. Focus on your exits.
Sketch tires.
That lap was a 144.9.
Two laps of tires. Really on brakes. Super late on that turn. Has me catching up again.
Sector 3 is green.
So hopefully what will happen is Kesby will get by me. And then Mac and him will get tangled up.
On your left, clear on the left side.
A bit of tunnel vision.
Green flag, sector one.
On your right.
It's fine.
Hold your line. Clear on your right.
The gap to grass behind is increasing. It's now 3.3.
He was definitely faster than me.
Gap in front has increased to 1.4 seconds.
Or hopefully I'll just hang on to more tires than those guys.
Yellow flag, sector 2. We think Kelly has gone off in turn 10. Green flag, sector 2.
Oof. Tough one. 40 minutes still, oh my god.
Thank you. was at 144.5.
Oh my god, that was terrible.
Graf is closing the gap. It's now 1.6.
I don't know what's going to happen. This is going to be an interesting 38 minutes. Shift down 3-2. Pass out.
The gap in front is now 1.4.
Third man in a train here. Oh, Mac.
Left side, all clear on the left.
How did you come back from that?
Left side, clear left.
Incident in sector 3. Sector 3 is yellow. Looks like P4 has binned it in. Sachs.
That's good for me. But now Norm is much closer.
Well done, Eric. This is great. Come on, keep nailing those exits. P3.
Too early still.
Coming up on a slower car.
Mr. Kruger.
The gap to Graf behind is increasing. It's now 1.7.
Oh god, no farts. Canberra, Carousel, Lake, Canberra, Carousel.
left side tires. Oh my gosh. Much better exit.
Yellow flag sector 2. Green flag sector 2. It looks like Vertelli has gone off in the hairpin. On your right, clear right.
Short shift, 3, 2, go ahead, carousel. Yes.
That's half distance. Fuel levels are fine.
Just happy to cruise. I'll take the podium.
You've just done a 145.1.
Tired, like it always does.
Gap to grass behind is now 1.1. Your last lap time was a 144.4.
I don't know if that gap to norm is bigger or smaller. I think it's smaller. He's slightly faster than me. Oh, did he spin? Oh, early. Oh, he's only 2 seconds behind me. Thank you.
That lap time was 144.3. Slower class car ahead.
Hopefully Norm will get caught up in these guys in traffic. James usually has pretty good situational awareness. Sean, sometimes not so much. So we'll see what happens.
Last lap was a 144.8. Yellow flag. Sector 1 is green.
Car on your right. All clear on the right.
Great. Because of that, Norm has gotten. So, unfortunately, it worked out in Norm's favor, not my favor.
Used half your fuel. All right, Eric, don't let this guy distract you.
Car on your left. All clear on the left.
P3.
All right, you're Sean. On your right.
So graph behind is increasing. It's now 1.4. Your lap time was 145.5.
Oh man. Whew. Early. Not a great one, but not a terrible one.
We think Dave has gone off in sacks. Sector 3 is clear, green flag.
Oh my gosh. It's a little early still.
Yellow flag in Sector 3. We think that Mazier has gone off in
Sachs.
Oh
no, Eugene. I say this every week, but... Oh, that was a dumb shift. I don't know why I did that.
Sector 3 is clear.
Lots of mistakes just happened.
Gap to grass behind is now 3.5.
Oh man, 3 seconds. That's good. He has made some kind of horrible error. So I can relax a little bit, but 20 minutes, there's a lot that can happen.
This is terrific. Exactly what we came here for. That's 20 minutes to go. 20 minutes. Lower class car ahead.
I need to be on the brakes a little earlier because I'm starting to run out of brakes. Well, tires really, but didn't need that shift. Oh boy, here, see? Got a good run through there. Oh, 49, jeez. Oh, that tire's really bad. Oh, Juggernaut. Because we 7.5 seconds ahead, I don't think I have any hope of catching him, but that's totally okay.
The gap to grass behind is increasing. It's now 4.7 seconds.
Oh wow, not paying attention.
The gap in front is increasing, it's now 9.4. You've just done a 145.0. Okay Eric, that's good consistency, keep it up.
I think there's enough time left in the race for me to catch him at half a second a lap, but I was half a second up on him.
Fifteen minutes to go.
Trying to be really gentle on that left front tire. Wow.
Incident in Sector 1. Sector 1 is yellow. We think that Galvin's gone off in Nord Curve. Green flag Sector 1. Car in front is Galvin.
44 was my last. 43, 152 on Ben. Jeez, there's no way I can catch him. That's okay. Just hold on to what we got. We got a whole time. Make a difference if we've got tires or not. Norm has caught up. That is not good. Oh, thanks, Gino.
Careful, car on your right. They're on
if you
your
would
right.
Block Norm, that would be amazing. No, that's not. That would not be sportsmanlike.
gap two. Galvin ahead is now 3.3.
Oh, am I catching somebody?
The gap to grass behind is now 3.3 seconds.
That's not good. Early. These tires are sketchy. Geared in. Brakes super early.
10 minutes to go. That's 10 minutes left. Okay, Eric, just keep hitting your marks. This is looking good.
Is so dead. Brakes, turn in.
That was at 144.2.
Thanks. Gear turn in. Okay. 6, 4, 3, 2. Oh, God.
The gap to Galvin in front is now 3.6.
So picked up some time.
Gap to grass behind is now 3.4.
3, 2. Oh God, they're really getting bad. Nice rotation. Oh yeah. It's okay to be the right front that I just dragged there. Seven minutes, oh my God.
Yes. And then...
Okay, Eric, you're reeling. Galvin in. The gap is now 1.4 seconds. On your right. Clear right.
Yes.
Good move, mate.
Oh, don't fuck it up.
This is great. P2.
P2, yes, Mike Jones. Can't believe you're still with me, but I appreciate it. Oh, sketchy.
Yellow flag, sector 3. It looks like Overton has crashed in. Mobile 1, Sector 3 is now clear. Hold your nerve, just keep it smooth, no mistakes.
Car on your right.
Dude!
They're on your right.
5 minutes to go, this is good. We'll be on the podium if we can keep it together.
Clear on your right.
Okay, Eric,
just gave me
had a bit of bodywork damage there.
Oh god, tires are so bad. Vision mega. Oh wow, no. Wow.
The gap to Galvin behind is increasing. It's now 0.9.
Minutes, oh my god. Gotta hold my concentration for a whole 3 minutes. Actually, probably more like 4 minutes.
Incident in Sector 1, a yellow flag. We think Overton has binned it in Nord Curve. Sector 1 is green.
Two minutes.
2 minutes to go. 2 minutes. We've got 10 minutes of fuel remaining. Incident in sector 3. Sector 3 is yellow.
Alright. Just on mezzanine 6. Shift, brakes, 3, 2, carousel, power out. Brakes, turn. Oh, good run out of there. Oh my god, I'm getting a cramp. Shit!
You've just done a 144.2.
Oh my god, I'm getting a cramp in my calf with 19 seconds left. This is fucking awful. I literally have a cramp in my throttle calf. I don't know what to do about it. It's getting worse. I could figure out how to drive with my other foot, I would.
Oh. Well done, Eric. Great drive.
Whoa.
On your right. All clear on the right.
Wow. Oh my gosh. Oh, nice. Oh man. Hell yeah! Woo! With the cramp and everything. Oh, jeez. That was nutty. Well, thanks for watching, Mike. I appreciate it.
Looks like everybody's in.
Yeah, thanks very much. So, well done, Frank.